To date, there are no human studies on the effects of legal market cannabis use on the experience of exercise. And so this study, we're specifically trying to figure out what impact commercially available cannabis products have on the experience of exercise, specifically focusing on common barriers to exercise. So how does cannabis influence pain during exercise? How does it influence enjoyment, motivation, exertion? We're seeing an increasing number of anecdotal reports in the media that people are using cannabis in combination with various forms of exercise. And there have been some recent population-based studies that have actually shown that cannabis users are more likely than non-users to meet physical activity recommendations.
I think it's important for science to understand just the basic mechanisms of exercise physiology and the endocannabinoid system. When I run for a really long time and I get kind of tired and just worn out, I get this thing kicks in when it makes the colors brighter and it makes my thoughts clearer. It makes me more emotionally attuned. And so like that's how I feel when I run, you know, like 30 plus miles. And then when I use cannabis and I run, and I get to feel that at a less intense mileage.
The study involves three different appointments at our on-campus exercise facility at CU. For the first appointment, folks drive in, they complete a baseline assessment, which asks them some questions about their exercise behavior and cannabis use, and then they participate in a 15-minute treadmill test where we essentially just figure out what heart rate range they should be at when they're engaging in moderate intensity exercise. And then at the end of that appointment, they're assigned to use either a THC-dominant flower strain or a CBD-dominant flower strain. For the cannabis exercise appointment, we have one of our research assistants drive the mobile lab to the participant's home. Once they arrive, the participant uses their assigned product in their own home, comes back out to the mobile lab, drive them back to the exercise facility, and they complete some surveys before and after a 30-minute exercise test. And then for the non-cannabis appointment, it's really similar. The only difference is that they're just not using cannabis before the exercise.
I don't know that I would say it necessarily relates to the controversy around performance enhancement. And my opinion is that it's definitely not performance enhancing, and it's psychologically enhancing. But I'm not gonna run farther when I'm stoned, you know?
So we're really conducting this study just to give policymakers and healthcare practitioners and the public at large just the information they need to make an informed decision.